All right, we're back here with Leighton. We just finished our playing lesson here on the 18th hole. Just want to kind of recap a few things with him and give him a few things to leave with, so that way when he leaves and I'm not here, he'll have something to kind of go off of. So first, I want to ask you in particular, what's one of the things that stuck out to you the most in terms of your pre-shot routine or picking a window or the KISS, keep it simple, stupid, or any of those things? What was like the one thing that kind of hit home for you?
Well, I'd say definitely, you know, tweaking my pre-shot routine with the apex, looking at that. I'd never really done that before.
Okay.
I'd always just kind of visualize or think of, oh, let me just hit a fade here or a draw here.
Yep.
And just aim at a target. Okay. And the apex does make me feel a lot more confident with my shot because it kind of feels like almost like a free throw.
Yeah.
A little bit.
So perfect. Yeah. Okay.
So just
cool.
like KISS, you know, keeping it simple. So
yep. All right. Perfect. Cool, man. So
definitely apex.
That's good because you're visual. You're a visual learning style, or that's your kind of characteristic as a learner, or that's what I've picked up at least. So in terms of that, that's a good thing that you picked apex because that's something that you can easily pinpoint. You can see it. You can visualize it. You can do all those things and make sure you're good. Now, in terms of recovery shots, I know we had a situation earlier today where you told me that yes, you could feel yourself hitting a nice good draw shot out of, you know, kind of a sticky situation versus just taking your medicine and chipping out into the fairway. But applying the apex window to that, how do you think you're going to be able to figure out, hey, should I go for this one or no? Should I just take out and chip out in the middle of the fairway, get myself back in? How are you going to figure that out going forward?
Well, I feel a lot more confident with the apex, especially with the recovery.
Yeah.
Just because now I know it's like, all right, even if I want to hit a really good shot, it's like, if I hit my recovery shot, I'll probably make a better score on
yes.
the hole. So that's kind of really all that matters.
Yeah, that's right. That's, so, that's the overall goal.
Definitely that.
Okay, so. Cool. Perfect. Well, and I think obviously, too, when we ended here, you had to get up and down a little bit. So our chipping lesson that we did. You know, obviously, I think what we nailed in is just make sure that your stance is the same throughout. And I think you can also apply that to when you're in those recovery shots or even when you're off the first tee. Just make sure that you are making sure that everything is simple. Is your stance the same? Is it repeatable? Is your chipping stance the same? Is it repeatable? Is selecting what kind of shot to punch out with, is that repeatable? And I think we have found a way to repeat that, I think. What do you think?
I agree. I think so as well. Just keeping it simple.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it's just a chip and a putt.
Yeah,
you know?
That's so right.
You ain't got to make it overcomplicated.
Exactly.
So,
all right,
the more
cool,
you overcomplicate
man.
Things, golf's going to be harder. So.
Exactly, and that's the name of it. So, perfect. Well, cool. So, if you feel good, I feel good.
I feel great.
All right, man. Well, thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Yeah,
appreciate
always.
It.
Yep. Pleasure.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.